A proposed synchronization of next year's midterm polls and a plebiscite for a new Philippine constitution. Senate President Miguel Zubiri says this is preferred by President Marcos Jr. as congressmen begin their own deliberations on charter amendments. RG Cruz has tonight's top story.
House lawmakers debated the nature of the Committee of the Whole, which was called Monday to work on amendments to the 1987 Constitution, even before their invited subject matter experts can begin their pitches. House Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro wonders if they have been convened as a constituent assembly, since House rules limit discussions on one bill to one topic per bill, while the resolution of both houses number 7 covers several topics.
Kasi yung RB87 natin, Mr. Chair, aside from sinasabi nating economic provisions, may nakikita tayo dito na hindi rin namang iba rin yung topic. Like for example, on education, on advertisement, etc. Ibig bang sabihin yan, without us knowing na kinoconvert natin itong Committee of the Whole na pinamumunuan ng Rules Committee, nang parang constituent assembly na tayo.
You can either characterize it as a constituent assembly or a legislative body. In both cases, we are exercising our constituent power, meaning the authority and the right of this Congress to amend or propose revision to the Constitution as provided for and as guaranteed by the Constitution.
This Committee of the Whole can never be considered as a constituent assembly.
Gonzalez says that because they went for a resolution of both houses, the approval of both chambers voting separately is required. Lagman insists the two chambers have to meet together to approve a new draft.
The representatives and the senators will meet in an assembly because it is a constituent assembly. They cannot be acting separately.
The words jointly assembled is only found in the 1935 Constitution. There is nothing that, there is no mention of the joint assembly in the 1987 Constitution.
House leaders insist no political amendments will be made.
Bagun ang ilang economic provisions na pumipigil sa pagpapasok ng mga negosyo mula sa ibang bansa. Mga negosyong lilikha ng trabaho at magpapasigla ng ating ekonomiya. Ito lamang ang pakay natin.
Congressmen maintain they are not undermining the Senate by conducting parallel hearings.
We also need to explain this to our constituents kung bakit nagkaganito. So para magkaroon ng mas magandang output, it is vital for us, for the House, to come up and to have our own deliberations on RBH7.
Senators meantime met with the President, and Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri claims the President believes the Senate and the House should vote separately. Zubiri adds the President prefers a plebiscite to coincide with the 2025 midterm elections. That's aside from fresh assurances that only economic amendments will be tackled and that the Senate will take the lead. Zubiri says they will try to finish the amendments by the end of the second regular session of the 19th Congress by May.
Kung gagawin natin yan, bago mag-eleksyon, gagastos po tayo ng 12 to 14 billion. Basta what is important is very clear din ang gusto ng Pangulo na isabay na lang sa halalan yung plebisito. Para sa ganun makasave po tayo.
The Commission on Elections says that they are ready to conduct a plebiscite whenever a new draft is approved by lawmakers. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.